Hello guys, welcome to my channel. This is William here, and for today I'll teach you how to dual boot or triple boot your PC with Ubuntu. I already have Elementary OS and Windows installed, and I'll teach you how to install Ubuntu. You'll have to follow the exact same procedure to first dual boot and then triple boot with any of Linux distros. Without any further ado, let's get started. First of all, go to the download page which I have linked in the description. Click on download and the desktop version. Here you will be presented with the Ubuntu download screen. Here you have also an option to try different Ubuntu flavors that are available. They're all free and they're all good. You can try any one of them if you want to. But for now, I'll show you how to install the normal available Ubuntu. So first click on download. Here is the options to donate. So you can either donate or you can just skip it by clicking on this. Since I've already downloaded, I'm not gonna show you that once again. Here I have mounted the drive, and this is the drive which I'll use to create a bootable USB. Format it, but it's not necessary since it'll be auto formatted when you'll create a bootable disk. It's done. Now go to the software Rufus, which I have linked in the description. Select the USB drive and then select the ISO. Here you have the ISO, open it, and you have it here, and click on start. Yes. Click on OK and then OK once again, and it'll start creating a bootable. Let me just quickly show you that the drive is being created. Earlier it was named Elementary. Now it'll be named Ubuntu. See? It's named Ubuntu now. Okay, so let me quickly show you a thing which I've got. That is to free up some space for the installation of Ubuntu or any other installation, Linux installation. So you have to go to shrink volume. Since I've already done that, I won't be doing that again, but I'll show you how to do that. Oh, here's the USB creation completed. Close. You can see the drive has been created. Here it shows the maximum available shrink space that you can free up. I wanted to free up 28 GBs, which I have already done, and I don't have it now, but if you have it, shrink will be available here. I'll say ideally you should have 20 GBs at least for the Ubuntu installation. Once you're done with that, restart your PC. I'll skip. Now go to your boot options, that will be like F12 or F2, and select the USB. Here in this menu, select install Ubuntu option, and once it's loaded, you'll be presented with this. Select the language you want to install Ubuntu in. Click on continue. Here, click on this, since it's necessary to install the required drivers, and you can also click on download updates. Now, different options are available, but choose the something else since I'm triple booting and you might want to do that in future. So this is a safer option. Okay, so first of all we need to find the free space which we created. Yeah, here it is. It'll be a bit different with from which it was in Windows. First create the swap area. Click on swap area. I'll say that 2 GB is sufficient for swap area, and I'll do exactly that. For information, I already have Elementary OS installed, and so this is the triple boot which I'm doing. Okay, it is done. Now this is not the free space, so beware. Yeah, this one, this 27313 MBs. First click on the icon, now create the mount area. Okay, it'll take a bit. Once it's done, select the EXE4 space that has been created. Okay, it is done. Let's see where that is, the XT4 space. Oh, not here, not here. Okay, click on install now and then click on continue. Now select your time zone. Here's the keyboard layouts you can choose from. I prefer the US English one. I'll go with that. Click continue. Now enter your username, your computer's name, and pick a username option will be autofilled. You can change them if you want to. And choose a password if you want to, or you can log in automatically. I'll choose a password for now. Okay, it's done. Click on install now. It will start installing. I'll skip that. Now click on restart now. Once you have restarted, you'll be presented with the Ubuntu Jira menu where you have the different OSs available. You can start any one of them. Now once the Ubuntu is loaded, put your password which you created, and now that's pretty much it. You have the keyboard shortcut screen that you'll be presented with, and you have successfully dual booted or triple booted your Ubuntu or any of the Linux installations.